Where we're at today is Brackett's Crossing, and we are here to present active shooter training and critical incident training to local businesses who, through the Chamber of Commerce, has organized this, and the Lakeville Public Safety Foundation and Lakeville Police Department. We're presenting to them, preparing them for active shooter events. We begin with a presentation, which Lieutenant Punchcar does, and then we go and break down into smaller tabletop discussions where they have one-on-one or smaller groups of more individualized attention on how to respond to active shooter incidents, whether it be in a bank or some sort of big business, or whether it be manufacturing. The participants will see two scenarios. They will see live firing, that's blank rounds, loud noises, a little running around, they'll see bad guys, they'll see police enter the building and neutralize a suspect, and we're expecting them to run hide fight as they're being trained and make a decision and go with it.
Lakeville is very cohesive and a tight-knit group, and so when we approached it to the Lakeville Police Department, they were very receptive, and they're already doing it for the schools, already doing it for the public employees, so it's just great to bring it out to the business community.
The people participating in this exercise today is your Lakeville Police Department. You will see our own reserve officers who are also committing time to this to be role players, and you'll see an actual member of our patrol division responding to the active shooter situation. This isn't new to Lakeville Police Department, but it is to the people we're presenting to for the most part. We train as an agency to prepare for active shooter incidents. That's why we have an active shooter team. But it's our obligation, we feel, to present it to the community so they can learn from it as well.
That partnership makes, you know, a business community feel a lot safer, that you know you can lean on the police department and the fire department, and you have the backing of the chamber and the Public Safety Foundation to know that this is going on and being prepared for it.
What am I hoping they get from this training would be that they have some tools and a skill set to bring back to their organization, wherever it be within the city of Lakeville, and something they can teach their co-workers and get them in the mindset of thinking, what would I do in this situation? What would I do in a critical incident? How would I respond in an active shooter? And bring it back to their organization where they work, their desk where they sit, and prepare for it.